Hello everyone, and welcome to the third episode of Style with Den. And I promised you I was going to bring you only the best, the cream of the crop, and my next guest fits all of those descriptions and more. Today, we have a Broadway performer, a beautiful woman, and a fitness goddess building an empire one kickball change at a time. It's the truth. I want to welcome you, Amanda Kloots.
Hello. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you so much for taking the time. This woman is busy, okay? So this is a moment I am just going to take advantage of it and run, because it's these small little blips on the screen you get. She's that booked and that intense. If you've been reading the New York Post lately, if you have been on any type of social media, chances are you've run across this lovely lady. She is taking the fitness world by storm, not just New York City, but nationwide with the release of her new workout videos. So we just want to talk a little bit about her and then get in on the action. I am going to take the class and give you my firsthand experience of how we're doing. So how are you? Welcome.
I'm good. Thank you so much for having me. It's nice to be here.
We are here at Studio B, which is a fantastic studio located in the heart of Chelsea. And today we're going to take your dance class, but I wanted to talk first of all about your career here in New York. Now, you were a dancer, you started?
Yes, I went to school here for musical theater, and I performed on Broadway and a Radio City Rockette. So kind of encompassed a lot of the performing world.
And one thing her clients will love is how humble she is. I would say arguably over the last decade, she has been the premier dancer on Broadway. Yeah. No, it's the truth, okay? I want to just say quickly, this moment that I have is the truth. I walked by Times Square. I think I came from an audition, was probably cut, sent on my way, thanks for the memories. And I walk by and I see this woman's face splashed on the marquee of Broadway show Good Vibrations.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about how it was when you found out that moment they were going to put you on the marquee.
That was really crazy. I have to say, that was my first Broadway show, my Broadway debut. I played the role of the bikini girl, so my job was to be in a bikini for most of the show.
And look damn good doing
and
it.
And so, you know, all of the things that you have to do mentally and physically to prepare yourself for that. And it was pretty exciting. I didn't know that they were going to do it. A friend of mine actually said, do you know that you're on 44th Street? And I was like, no, what? And then I went and looked at it. And I was like, oh my gosh, which was crazy.
It
was
really I remember fun. It was unbelievable. She is just giving you face on that marquee, living her life. And she also, as she said earlier, was a Radio City Rockette. Yeah. How was that in terms of that grueling schedule?
Oh, Rockettes is exactly that. It is a grueling schedule, far more so than Broadway. You're doing 17 shows a week compared to 8 shows a week in a Broadway show schedule. And at the time, they still had 5 show days. So I was doing 5 show days at Radio City Music Hall. I mean, I can't even tell you the amount of kicks I did. And that stage is a steel stage. So you're in a 3-inch heel kicking on a steel stage. I mean, it is intense on your body. You're in ice baths every day, massages. Any time you have to rest, you take it. But it is, again, some, you know, of the best memories I've ever had in my performing career, for sure.
I mean, I think that's so interesting to hear, is that we make it look so beautiful and presentational, but they're athletes, and it's grueling. And I think that really prepared you for your career now as a fitness instructor, did it not?
Yes, no, absolutely. I think that performers really do make great fitness instructors, because we know how to just be on. Mm-hmm. We know how to, like, we're tired.
Who, me?
You know, I mean, it doesn't matter if you're tired. It doesn't matter if you had a fight with your boyfriend. It doesn't matter if if your business is in shambles. You walk through that door, you put a face on, and you go.
The show must go on.
The show must go on. And, you know, I have to say, I went 3 years ago, I went through a divorce, and it was definitely the hardest thing I've ever had happen to me in my entire life. But fitness and teaching fitness completely saved me because of that reason. I had to walk in the door and just pretend that nothing else was happening. And those endorphins of teaching all day, I would leave that studio and I would leave my clients, and I had forgotten about, you know, everything that was bringing me down. And it really did, honestly, help me get through my those 3 years of my life. I was really tired.
Unbelievable. You know? Right there, even though we're saying about being on and putting on this performance, the transparency that is there. I mean, that's something that you want who's leading your fitness journey and that you're trying to identify with. This isn't just about doing crunches, it's about inspiring people. And for Amanda to be so open and honest and forthcoming, that's what you get in this experience on top of working your butt off.
Well, thank you. No, I honestly, I did an interview a couple of days ago and she said something like, what's your fitness philosophy? And I said, you know, if I can have people walk out of my classes saying, that was so hard, but also the most fun I've ever had and I can't wait to come back. That's kind of what I hope to have people leave the door with. I don't want to be, you know, the biggest, the baddest, the meanest, you know, rah, I don't want to yell in your face. I want you to work hard and understand why you're working hard, but I also want you to have a good time and have fun.
Oh my goodness, if that's not a reason enough to take her class, I don't know what is, but I do have another reason. It is that she not only is teaching these cardio dance classes and inspiring and a long slew of celebrity clients, and she's very much in demand. She's also an original innovator of the rope class.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, so I had read an article a while ago about how jump roping burns more calories than running and swimming. And I'm not a runner. I never have been, despite my 1 year of track in high school.
what was your event?
Turtles.
Yes. Oh, these legs. Forget it. Should be like, and we're good. Goodbye.
But I was miserable. I've never been a runner. And swimming too. I love the pool and I love water, but I just never was a good swimmer. So I picked up the jump rope because I remembered loving jumping rope as a kid. And I thought, well, you know, this burns a ton of calories, then let's start jumping rope. And I was training a private client one day and we were warming up with the jump rope, and she's kind of just this young, fun, spirited girl that I knew I could kind of throw anything at her. And while we were jumping, I had this idea. I was like, we're just not putting this thing down. Mm. And I'm going to go 55 minutes and I'm going to see what I can create with this one piece of equipment. And I kind of just broke it down into, let's do arms, let's do abs, let's do legs, let's do, you know. And we made it through the whole hour and we both were on the floor, and she looked at me and she was like, that was really hard, Amanda. And I was like, I know. And then I kind of was like, I think I have something here. And it's funny, you know, business is funny. I pitched it to a couple people and everyone was kind of like, oh, I don't know, a jump rope class, no. How would you do that? You know, people would be hitting each other. And I knew I had something. I knew it was something cool and innovative that, you know, that you used to do on the playground, but now is like this piece of equipment that every boxer uses, and who doesn't want to be a boxer in the gym, you know, doing all those cool tricks. And so I knew I had something, and so I refined it and I made a class that a beginner jumper could do and an advanced jumper could do, and debuted it here at Studio B in April of 2016. It's been over a year and a half.
And it's a huge success. And we're going to roll you some clips on from her video that you can find on her website. And then we'll also have that for you on stylewithden.com. Another thing that was interesting, just as she was speaking of that, it goes along with the philosophy that I speak, is that you're going to hear no's. You're going to hear rejection. People are going to have strong opinions. And as a businesswoman, you have to really be staunch in your ideas and strong, and Amanda's certainly a testament to that.
Well, and it's funny because relating back to the performing, how you said how does performing correlate?
Oh.
I mean, Dennis and I, you know, when you're performing, you're told no.
Oh my God.
More times than you're told yes, and so yes, I think that, you know, being a performer and having that, you know, no for me was like, okay, that's no for now, but that's not like, closed door. That's just, you don't think it's a good idea. I still think it's a good idea. So, you know, it's the same as performing. You get told no, and then you're just like, great, okay, next day you're back on your feet, and you're like, who's going to do it with me next?
And you know what? You hear that no, and then you come here to Studio B, and you dance it out. And and you really, the endorphins that you had brought up, too, I certainly can relate to that. It can change your entire perspective on things.
Yes, absolutely.
Just getting out of your head for a bit, focusing on something else. Dancing, sweating, all of that is such a positive thing, and it's something that Amanda does quite well. Okay, before we get on our feet and into this class, I have one little dream that I need. You know how I do my little dreams, my little moments? Well, I'll never, ever be a Rockette. Fact of life. But you know what? Here at Style It Den, we make dreams happen. She's like, girl, you're already doing this to me. I know. Just literally, I want to be in the row and just maybe three kicks. Okay, so my Rockette lesson dream come true moment is happening now. So I'm standing next to you where I'm picturing it, Radio City, 5,000 people, the kids screaming, give me my, I want my Rockette, I want my Santa Claus. And here we go, what do I do?
Okay, so your arms are gonna come behind you and you're gonna go behind me and I'm gonna cut in here. Good, now so when you do Rockette kick, you never touch the person's back behind you. That's a misconception.
As I'm touching her back.
Yes, and
okay.
If you do touch the person's back, you get yelled at. So it's a no-no.
Okay.
It's called feeling the fabric. So I'm like feeling Dennis's shirt, but I'm never pressing into him. Because again, it's like the domino effect. If one girl goes down and everyone's pressing on each other, everyone would go down. That never happens, though he has the Rockette perfect.
Perfection.
Obvious. So you want to have, and you kind of have to a little bit arch your back and you stick out your chest as if you are kicking to that third level of Radio City Music Hall, and it goes way up.
Yes, it does.
Been. So you're kind of looking up and out. And again, you're going to jump first and then you're going to kick that right foot and it goes right to your eye level, okay? Not
so
higher,
right
not
to the kick?
Yes, and your foot is parallel, so you never want to turn that foot out like we used to.
I know, I want to just give you that
yes,
right now.
No, you have okay. to do a parallel. So we're going to do just, we'll do four of them and just to practice a little bit. Jump, kick, jump, kick, jump, kick, jump, kick. Yeah. All right,
ready.
A 5, 6, 7, wait, jump, up, two,
yeah! I did it! I did it! Thank you so much. And now I think it's time for us to take Amanda's class and really burn it out and live life.